Hi guys, good morning. This is our third lecture of digital digit number system, binary, octal, decimal, hexadecimal, and their conversion of from one number system to another number system. The second lecture we have seen the data representation, magnitudes, that is sign and unsigned, complements, ones complements and second complements, all the arithmetic operations, binary, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and the binary codes, that is BCD code 8421, 2421, 84 minus 1, 2 minus 1, access 3 gray code, and ASCII code. Now, in this lecture, we are going to see the logic gates and Boolean algebra. Now, the logic gate, there are three types of gate. One is the basic gate. That basic gate is represented AND, NOT, OR. Universals gate, that is the NAND and NOR. We'll see why it is called the universal gate. And the other gate, there is a XOR and XNOR. Now the basic gate is very important. That is AND, NOT, and OR. NOT. NOT is just the complement of input. See, suppose the case is one, only two stage, only one is input and one is output. This is the circuitry symbol of the NOT gate. If you are giving an input is zero, if the case is one, if A is equals to zero, so B is equals to what you will get, one, just the complement of zero to one or one to zero. If the case two, if you are giving an input 1, so you will get the output 0. That is the complement. It's like a 1's complement. In 1's complement, they use the NOT gate over there. This is the truth table of the NOT gate. And this is the Boolean expression. What the B is the output and A is the input. So the output is equals to input. So what is this Boolean expression? Output B is equals to A complement. Suppose A is equals to 0, the output is 1. If A is equals to 1, the output is 0. So this is called as the Boolean expression, right? So now the next is the AND gate. AND gate means both the condition has to satisfied, first and second. So it AND gate has the minimum 2 input, maximum n number of input, and you will get 1 output. This A and B is an input. This is a symbolical representation of AND gate, and C is your output. Circuitry, if there is a 2 switch A and B and C is output, suppose the first condition A and B, suppose A is open. If it is a 0, that means it is open. If it is a close, that means it is a 1. So if A is open, B is open, circuit is not complete, to C obviously is 0. Alright. Second condition is that if A is open, B is close, but still the circuit is not completed, to C is equals to 0, output will be a 0. The third condition, A is closed, B is open, so the again C is unclosed, C is not completed to the conditions, so C is equals to 0. If the fourth condition, A and B both are closed, that means A is equals to 1, B is equals to 1, so C is equals to 1. So now it is AND means it is a multiplication of operation. If any one of the input is 0, output will be a 0. So in this condition, in an AND gate, both the input should be a 1, then only output will get the 1. This is a logical notations. A dot B is equals to C. So that is C is equals to A dot B. Now, this is a symbolical representation of AND gate. This is the truth table. There are A and B are the input, C is output. If both the input are 0, output is 0. either any one input is 0, output is 0. If both the inputs are 1, output is 1. So this is what the truth table of the AND gate. And the Boolean expression is equals to C is equals to 8 AND. This dot means what? It is a AND. So A AND B. So C is equals to AB, we can say that. So C is equals to AB. This is a Boolean expression of AND gate. What is a Boolean expression of NOT gate? It is a B is equals to A complement. These are very important as we are going for the Boolean's algebra. Now the OR gate. OR gate means at one condition, either one input is 1, so output will get 1. This or that. So that is the OR gate condition. Current flow if either switch is closed, either A switch or B switch, still the circuit will complete. So suppose if both the switch are open, this is the symbolical representation of OR gate. So now it is logical notation is C is equals to A plus B. So this plus is denoted OR and dot is denoted AND. So we can say that C is equals to A or B. A or B. If A or B means either one switch is closed, still the circuit will open or close. Suppose both the switch are open, the case 1, A or B. So A or 0 or 0, output will be a 0. Suppose the case B is closed. Suppose switch B is closed. So 0 or 1. This is the 0 means A switch and 1 means it is a B switch. So output is 1. So next condition is that so A will close and B will open. So the 1 or 0. So output still is 1. And last condition is both the switches are closed, still the output is 1. So what we can conclude that either any one of the input is 1 in OR gate, either any one of the input is 1, output will be a 1, right? So in AND gate, either any one of input is 0, output will be a 0, right? AND gate, 0. Output 0. OR gate, either any one input is 1, output will be a 1. This is the symbolical circuits. OR gate, 2 inputs are there and C is output. This is a truth table. There is a 4 condition. If it is a 2 input, 4 conditions are. If it is a 3 input, then 2 to the power 3, that is a 8 conditions are there. 2 input, that is a 4 condition. Either this condition, this condition, this condition, this. Both are 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So what will be the output for that condition is, if no input is 1, all the inputs are 0, output is 0. If one input is 1, still output is 1. If one input is 1, still output is 1. And both the inputs are 1, still the output is 1. And this is the Boolean expression of OR gate. C is equals to A or B. Now the next, buffer. Buffer is a sort of storage device. Means whatever we are giving the input, the same output will give. It is just the difference between the NOT gate and the buffer. NOT gate means your input will complement in the output. There is a one bubble sort of, this is right in NOT gate. And buffer, you don't have any that or not here, right? So whatever we are giving input, same will be a output. That is called as the buffer gate. Generally in memories, we are using this buffer gate. Whatever we are giving the input, same has to be stored into the buffer. So what is the symbolical representation of buffer? This way, this is your truth table. Whatever you are giving the A, output will be a same B. Whatever you are giving a input, A is equals to 1, output will be a 1. This is a Boolean expression, B is equals to A. This is what output is equals to input Boolean expression. Now NAND gate. It is just same as the AND gate. AND gate is complement of NAND gate. AND gate plus NOT gate. It forms the NAND gate. AND gate, the output of AND gate is connected with a NOT gate. So whatever the output it comes, that is a NAND gate. So just this dot means it is a NOT gate. There are two input and C is input. It can be a minimum two input, maximum it can be a n number of input. It's depend upon the what kind of IC is manufactured. Now the truth table, just complement of a AND gate, right? If both the inputs are, what is a truth table of AND gate? If any one of the input is zero, output will be a zero. So now if I'm connecting this output with NOT gate, what output I will get? 1 1 1 0. So what is the output of NAND gate? It is a 1 1 1 0, just the complement of AND gate. Now how will be a Boolean expression? C is equals to A AND B complement. This is what NOT gate. A AND B complement, NOT gate, right? So this is the Boolean expression. Same as NOR gate, it is just complement of OR gate. Same as NOR gate, it is a just complement of OR gate. So symbolical representation in this way, there are the two input and these notches will make the difference between the NOR gate and OR gate. If it is a notch is here, this is what not. If it is notch is here, that is a NOR gate. If it is a notch is not there, that is a OR gate. See this. Now this OR gate, this is a OR gate. If we are using this output with one NOT gate and then the output, what is this output is complemented. Suppose this output is complemented, what output will be a NOR gate? So C complement, that is 1 0 0 0, that is a truth table of NOR gate. C here 1 0 0 0, that means both the input has to be a zero, then only the output is one. Just you remember these two gates, AND, NOR, AND or NOT, and these two gates are just forming a basic gate plus NOT gate, so you will get the NAND gate or NOR gate. How it is the Boolean expression? That is C is equals to A plus B, A or B. This is called OR. A or B complement. A or B complement. C is equals to. Now the other gates are XOR gate. Now XOR gate means there are two inputs. See, symbolical representation is the same as OR, just only this curve is before the OR gate. These two are the input output. Here both the input are same. Both the input are same, output is zero. Either both the input are zero or both the input are one, output will be a zero. Suppose both the inputs are different, either 01 or 10, output is, it is a one. That is a XOR gate. Symbolical representation is C is equals to A XOR. This is called XOR B. C is equals to A XOR B. Now the XNOR is just the complement of XNOR is just the complement of XOR. This is presented here, the NOT gate. So now what will be the XOR gate? If both the input are same, output will be a zero. Now here both the inputs are same, output will be a one. Now see in X NOT gate, both the inputs are 0, output is 1. Both the inputs are 1, output is 1. Here, both the inputs are different, output is 0. Now, what will be the Boolean expression? C is equals to A, X or B complement. This is called as the XNOR, exclusive NOR gate. Right? This is called the exclusive NOR gate. C is equals to A, X or B complement. Now, these are the summary of all gate. AND gate, A and B are the complement. So, your output is AB. OR gate, NAND gate, just NOT gate is there, AB complement. And this is a NOT gate, A complement. OR gate, A and B is the output, A or B is. NOR gate, it is a OR gate's complement, A or B complement. This is XOR and XNOR gate. Now in this gate we have a logical gate ICs, right? Now this is 74 series is for the gate IC series. Now this 7432 COD 2 input OR gate, this we are going to use in our lab session. I'm just explaining. This is a 14 pin IC. 7 is ground and 14 is VCC. VCC means plus 5 volt. Our digitals is work with only the 0 and plus 5 volt. Nowadays it is work with 3.3 voltage also, right? So now either the 0 condition means it is a ground and 1 condition means it is a plus 5 volt. So this is a 14 pin IC. Notch is there. It is start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Now here in this IC has a 4 gate, right? The first 2, 1 and 2 are the input, output is 3rd. 4 and 5 is the inputs, output is 6. 9 and 10 is the input, 8 is the output. And 12 and 13 is the input and 11 is the output. So this is a OR gate IC. If I'm giving both VCC here, 11, 13 and 12, what I'm giving 1 1. So what if I'm connecting LED in this pin, so why my LED will glow? If I'm giving both are the ground 0 0, my LED will not glow. So this we have to do the verification of gate, verification of truth table of gates. Now this is practically we have to use in this 7408. You should remember the IC's number, that is 7432 is OR gate, 2 input OR gate IC. 7408 COD is 2 input AND gate IC. So here you will get same as it is also the 14 pin IC. 7 and 4 is the ground and VCC, and there are the 4 gates. Just the IC's number is 32 and 08. That's the difference. And this IC will perform the truth table of AND gate. And this IC will perform as the truth table of OR gate. Same as NOT gate. This is also 7404. So it is a series of 74. So 04 is a NOT gate. 08 is a AND gate. And 32 is OR gate. They will perform the truth table of NOT gate, AND gate and OR gate. Now here the 6 gates are there. Same, 7 and 14 are the ground and VCC respectively. And here 1 is input, 2 is output. 1 is 3 is input, 4 is output. 5 is input, 6 is output. Same as the other size. Now these are the XOR ICs. NAND IC, NOR IC and NAND IC. So this is NOR, it will perform same as 14 pin IC. This is 7402 is NOR IC. 7432 is OR IC and 7402 is NOR IC. Again, but just the structure is different. Here 1 is output, 2 and 3 is input. 5 and 6 is input, 4 is output. right? So you should know that which pins are input and which pins are output. While doing a performance, you should have a data sheets of this IC. So you will come to know the pin diagram, pin descriptions, which pin is the ground, which pin is the VCC, which are the input pins, which are the output pins, and how many gates are there, how many inputs are there, and what is the pin of the output. So that description you should know that while performing the practicals. So 7402, 7400, same as NAND. It will verify the truth table of NOR gate. This will verify the truth table of NOT gate. And this is one special example I have put it there. 74133. It is not only the two input of all. It can be an n number of input. This is 13 input NAND gate IC. See, this is a 16 pin IC. There are various type of ICs if you go to net and search there, okay, how many inputs are there, the NAND gate, and what are the ICs are available. This is 16 pin IC, 8 and 16 are the VCC, rest all are the input and 9 is the output. Now if it is a NAND gate, any one of the input is 0, your output will be a 1. Output will be a 1, just reverse of a AND gate. So this is, I just put the example, there can be a n number of inputs to the gate. It is not like that, say only two input, but it is a minimum of two input, maximum it will be a n number of input, right? These two ICs are the XOR and XNOR IC 7486. This will verify same 14 pin IC. This will verify the XOR truth table. And this is 747266. This is the XNOR IC. It will verify the truth table of XNOR. See, this is a XNOR. This is a XNOR. See, pins, input and output. This is 1 and 2 are the input, 3 is output. 5 and 4, 6 are the input, 4 is a output. That you should know that you should, while performing the practicals, you should refer the database of that particular ICs, right? Now we'll come to the Boolean algebra. So whatever this logical expression, it will written into the equation that is called as Boolean's equation, right? So what is there? The Boolean algebra. So the Boolean constant, there are zero and is add to the zero and Boolean variables that can only take the value 0 and 1 only. 0 and 1 only. Boolean function. Each of the logic functions such as AND, OR, NOT are represented by symbols are described above. So that is a Boolean function. Now they have the theorems of Boolean. The basic theorems of Boolean is first. There are 9 theorems in a Boolean algebra. We have to follow that as per the mathematical Pythagoras theorem we have, you know, same as here Boolean algebra's theorem. The T1 is properties of 0, right? This means if 0 is ORing with any input, suppose A is the input, right? Either the, if A is the input, either A will be 0 or A will be 1. If it is a 0 A, so still the output is 0. If it is A is 1, still the output is 1. So whatever the value of A, that will be the value of output. In these properties, 0 plus A is A. 0, a 0 or A means if any variable is ORing with 0, your value will be a that particular variable, right? But any variable you are ending with 0, your value will be a 0. This is the properties of 0, right? The properties of 1. 1 or A. So any value of variable is ORing with 1, the obviously value will be a 1, right? So this is 1.
1 is ORing with 0, still the value is 1. Suppose A is equals to 1, 1 is ORing with 1, still the value is 1, right? So any value is ending with 1, it is depend upon that value, whether the value is 0 or 1. So the A dot 1 is equals to 1. A and A, 1 and A is equals to A value. If A is 0, output will be a 0. If A is 1, output will be a 1. So these are the properties of 0 and properties of 1. This is a theorem 1 and theorem 2. Same as the theorem 3 is the commutative law. So A or B, it is the same as B or A, right? This is called the commutative law. A or B, it is the same as B or A, or A and B, it is the same as B and A, right? This is the same. Suppose if we say that 2 plus 5 is equals to 5 plus 2, right? 2 into 5 is equals to 5 into 2. The same law is called as the commutative law. Now the fourth theorem is the associative law. A or B, bracket, or C, it is the same as A or into bracket B or C, right? We will prove all these theorems in algebra. Just we have to go through the theorems. Associate law, right? A and B and complete C is same as A and bracket A and B and C, right? This is a associative. Distributive law, that is A into bracket and A and, this is and, right? And bracket B or C. So what it will be? A and B or A and C. A and B or, this is or, A and C, right? A or B and C, that means A or B and A or C. Either A and B or A or C. That is the distinction. A or A complement B. So what? This complement, right? A and A complement is A plus B. This is a distributive law. This law is already, we'll see the commutative law, how we will verify. These are A and B are the input. So 0 or 0, AB. So output will be a 0, 1, 1, 1. And if you are doing B or A, the same is output is 0, 1, 1, 1. So this condition is satisfied. Second is A dot B. A dot B. Any one of the input is 0, output will be a 0. And B dot A, any one of the input is 0, output will be a 0. So this theorem is proved. So all the theorems are proved in this way. Now, distributive law. We can say that. See, A plus A or B. This is your OR gate, right? Here it comes, the input is A or B. It is A or B input is ending with A. So this is A. So this A or B is ending with A. What will be the X output? X is equals to A and B or C, right? The same as A and B is the input, AB. So this A is the same. A and C is the input of A. And this AB or AC. So this X will be a AB or AC. This is a symbolical representations of Boolean algebraic equation. The output of this X will be a same as output of this X. Now here the three inputs are there. So how many stages are there? 2 to the power 3 means 8 combination. 8 combination, we'll see in the latter how we'll form the combinations, right? T6 theorem. Theorem 6, it is the identity theorem. A or A, same variable is ORing with A, that value will be A, or A and A, the value will be A, only A, that is the identity variable. Absorption or redundance law, that is A or A and B. So what will be the output? Only the A, B will vanish. It is a redundance, absorption. B will absorb that. A and B, A or B. So that is A. So these two are very important. A and A or A and B is equals to A. B will vanish here. Now A and A or B, that is A, A only, B will vanish, right? So this is complementary law. X or in X complement, what is the value output will be 1. Suppose X is equals to 1. 1 or 0, output is 1. Suppose X is equals to 0. 0 or 1, output will be a 1. Same, X dot X complementary. X and X complementary output will be a 0. Because suppose X is 0, so the output is 0. X is 1, so X complement is 0, the output is 0. So this is what the complementary law. Involution law, that is X double complement. X is equals to 0. Single complements, what it comes? 1. And again, 1 is complemented, what is comes? 0. So the 0 is the previous value of X, right? So the, it, if it is a double complement, so it comes the previous value. Now the De Morgan's theorem, theorem number 10. This is very important. X plus Y complement is equals to X complement and Y complement, right? X plus Y is whole complement is equals to X complement and Y complement. This we'll see. We have to do the practicals on this also. X dot Y whole complement is equals to X complement or Y complement, individual complement. Here the whole complement of X and Y results, that is a complement, equals to individual X complement, that ORing with individual Y complements. De Morgan's theorem. De Morgan's theorem provides the mathematical verification, the equivalency of NAND gate or the negative OR gates, or equivalency of NOR gate or the and the negative AND gate, right? Now this is X and Y complement. So any complement means it comes the NAND gate, that is equals to individual X complement or Y complement, or here it is used the OR, right? This is the complement of two or more NANDed variable is equivalent of OR of the complement of individual. Suppose three inputs are there, X, Y, Z. What it comes? X dot Y dot Z and whole complement, that is equals to X complement or Y complement or Z complement. So that is the De Morgan's theorem. Now the second is the complement of two or more ordered variable is equivalent to the NAND gate of complement of individual variable. X or Y whole complement, that is equals to X complement and Y complement. Suppose if it is a three variable, X plus Y plus Z, its whole complement, that is equals to X complement dot Y complement dot Z third complement. So this is the De Morgan's theorem we have to verify. We can see that one input, that is x and y is the input, right? So x dot y, what it is come? X dot y, any one of the, if two inputs are zero, output is zero. If one input is zero, output is zero. If one input is zero, output is zero. If both the inputs are one, output is x and y. This is x and y is complement. So this is complement. So 0 to 1, 0 to 1, 0 to 1, 1 to 0. Clear? Now this is part is. Now the next is x complement. X complement, what is the x? 0, 0, 1, 1. So what is x complement? 1, 1, 0, 0. See there. 1, 1, 0, 0. Now what is a y? 0, 1, 0, 1. So y complement is 1, 0, 1, 0. See. 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Now or. This is or means 1 plus 1. 1 or 1. Output is 1. 1. Any one of the input is 1. So output is 1. Any one of the input is 1, output both are 0. Now see, this is equals to this. Hence, it is proof the De Morgan's theorem. Now, we'll take one example how we will solve the Boolean expression. This is the three input, that is A, B, C. So, three input, how many combinations are? 8. 2 to the power number of input. 2 to the power 3 is equals to 8. So the combination is A, B, C. So now the first case is all are 0. Second case is 0, 0, 1. Third case is 0, 1, 0. Fourth case is 0, 1, 1. So this is 0. This is 1. This is 2 to the power 0. We have seen that. 2 to the power 1 and 2 to the power 2. So 2 to the power 2 means it is a 4, 2 and 1. So the 4 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7. When it comes to the 7, all inputs are 1. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now, see in first case. Now, suppose all inputs are 0, right? 0 and 0, output will be a 0. 0 is inverted 1. So, this input of AND gate is 1, 0, output is 0. OR gate, both the inputs are 0, output is 0, output will be a 0. Now the next case is 0, 0, 1. This is next case, right? So the both the inputs are 0, output will be a 0, right? This is 0 to 1. This NOT gate, 0. Both the input are 1, output of NAND gate is 1. Now any one input is 1, output will be a 1. So the Y is equals to 1. Now see the third case. 0, 1, 0. So the input is 0, 1. Output will be a 0 after this NAND gate. Now here the 0 is input. So output of NOT gate is 1. That is the input of NAND gate. And 1, 0 is 0. If both the inputs are 0, again output will be a 0. Now we'll see the third case. 0, 1, 1. Now this is any one of the input is 0, output will be a 0. Now here the 0 is output of NOT gate is 1 and both the input of NAND gate is 1, output will be a 1. Now in this OR gate, one input is 0, another input is 1, output will be a 1. What we will get? The 1 output. Now the third case is 1, 0, 0. So both the 1 and 0 output will be a 0. This will be a 0 input to the NAND gate and 0 output will be a 0. Both the input of OR gate is 0, output will be a 0. Next case. It is 1, 0, 0. Take 1, 0, 0. So now this is here the 1 and 0. So any one of the input of this NAND gate is 0, output will be a 0. Now this comes the 1, it comes to output of NOT gate is 0, that will be the input of AND gate. So now 0, 1, again output is 0. Both the input of OR gate is 0, output will be a 0. For this condition, output will be a 0. Now the third condition is 1, 1, 0. Now this is 1, 1, output will be a 1. This is inverse 0 to 1. Again, this is 0, 0, output will be a 0. Now the input of OR gate is, one input is 1 and another input is 0. Any one of the input is 1, output will be a 1. So this is Y is equals to 1. Now in the last case, this is 1, 1, output is 1. Now this is 1 to 0. So output of NAND gate is 0. Again, any one of the input of OR gate is 1, output will be a 1. Now this is the circuit. This is a truth table. Now we'll have to form the Boolean algebraic equation. Now how many these are these? This is 1 in output, this 1 and this 1. For this 1, what is the input is? 1 is there. Now see, 0, 0, 1. And for this, 0, 1, 1. 0 is common. 0 is common, right? So those are the common that we'll have to take first, right? That is 0 is common means it is a complement. And now see, the C is common. 1 for this input, this output is C is 1, and for this output C is 1. Only it will change B 0 to 1. So the leave B. So what is the Boolean algebraic equation is there? A C, A complement C. For this 2, 1, right? For this, so A will is the same, B is same, only C is changed. So leave that, and both are the 1, 1. So this is what A, B. So Y is equals to A, B plus A complement C. So now in this output, A is 0, and this output is also A is 0. So the A complement 0. This is what the Boolean equations. So now in your exam, either you will get the truth table from that. So you have to get it the Boolean expression. From that, you have to draw the circuit. Or you will get the circuit. You have to find out the equation. You have to find out the Boolean truth table. Now see the equation. Now here A and B. A and B. A complement here C. A complement C, and A and B is ORing with A complement and C. So what is your output? A and B plus A OR A complement and C, right? So this is your equation. So all these three are depends on each other, your truth table, your Boolean equation, and your circuit also, right? Now this is why we called as the NAND gate is a universal gate, because by using a NOR gate, two or more equation, we can form the basic gate, that is a NOT, OR and NOT. Suppose a NAND gate has two input, both the input are same, output will be a inverse, right? So this is what the truth table of NAND gate. 0, 0, it's 1. 0, 1, it's 1, 1, 0, it's 1, and 1, 1 is 1. So now, suppose both the inputs are 0, output is 1, and suppose both the input are 1, output is 0. So this is a truth table of NOT gate. So we can design the NOT gate by using a NAND gate and NOR gate. And NOR gate is also same. Both the inputs are 1, output will be a 1. Both the inputs are 1, output will be a 0. So this is a truth table of NOT gate. So by using a NOT gate, by using a NOR gate, we can form the NOT gate, right? The same as by using two or more NAND gate, we can find the combination of AND gate, OR gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, OR gate. So by using a NAND gate, we can form the AND gate also. By using a NAND gate, we can form the OR gate also. Same as by using a NOR gate, we can form AND gate. By using a NOR gate, we can form the OR gate. So that's why these gates are called as the universal gate. This practically we have to prove these circuits, right? Practically we have to prove how it is a universal gates. So that's why NOR gate and NAND gate is called as universal gate, because by using this gate we can form the basic gates, that is the NOT, NAND and NOR. By using a NOR gate also, by using a NAND gate also. So that's why these gates are the universal gates. Now these books is for the reference. You can refer these books, Digital Electronics by A.P. Godse and Dr. D.A. Godse, and Digital Electronics by A. Anand Kumar. Thank you, girls. If any questions, you can send the, you can ask me the questions. And the assignment is displayed on the Google Drive, and go through the lectures, and please let me know your queries also. Thank you, guys, once more.